Hi, my name is Bob Greener, and I'm a volunteer with the Martin Fleischmann Memorial Project. I am looking at the knee and the coral twist. So I'm going to focus on the top end of the knee here and the coral twist. Yes.
The one you try to store, yeah?
Yes.
This one?
That's the one. Yeah, perfect. I'm going to take a microscopy image. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Interesting. 66% carbon in this section here. Okay. Thank you. Interesting. So it appears copper where this is cut, which is denser than iron. And down here there is zero copper on the outside. Then you have the boundary where you get this carbon, and then on inside you get copper. Isn't that a thing? That is mighty strange. Let's see if that fits over there. Thank you. that's got zinc in it. Now there's another thing that's having even copper. Well, look at this. You've got chromium, iron, and nickel. Add an alpha particle, you get zinc. So this sample was iron, and with a high voltage electrostatic field and interacting RF, it bent and twisted.
Mm-hmm.
Coal. Same as this. That's aluminium. Well, originally. And there is a little triangle in here, and I'm looking on the edge of the triangle. So this on the outside is the normal steel, which is, you look here. We're on the outside, yes. And you've got iron, chrome, and nickel. Okay? Now you go across the boundary there, and you have a sudden layer of carbon, a pulse of carbon, and then on the inside, you have zinc inside that little bit, and this is a heavier element. So the iron and the chromium and so on has gone down to almost nothing, or very little. Sorry, the iron's gone back up there. Sorry, over here, in these areas here. The iron has dropped 14%, the chrome is basically not there, the nickel is not there, and you now have zinc. It's a collapse of matter without touching it. What do you think of that? And look, we have another one here, same story. So, except here we have copper. So you've got the steel as it started on the outside, iron and chrome, okay. Come across the boundary, we have a burst of carbon,
yep.
And then on the inside we have copper, and then whatever that is.
Hmm.
And I imagine this story will be the same all the way around here, so.
And have you looked at this piece?
No.
This may be very something
lead,
tiny.
Lead. But lead is as heavy as you're going to get. And what's this peak here? This is nickel. There's some residual nickel, but it depends where we are. Okay. We're on a different particular. Let's have a look where this is maximum copper. Can we hold it there? Does it hold it?
I don't know.
Right. And so. Maybe. Go there.
So
there.
This is spectrum for the whole line.
Yeah.
You cannot.
Well, maybe. Well,
I think so. We will have it soon that the spectrum is evaluated at each pixel, completely individual. I'm not completely sure if we have it already in the software.
Now, could this be low counts and it's just giving a wrong number? It doesn't seem to be complaining there, but maybe. I've got the same story over here, but this there is
unfortunately each line can be different intensity.
Yeah.
So bigger peak doesn't mean bigger concentration.
Okay.
Necessarily.
No. Okay, so.
But it was just
I think this is lead here.
So if you just add lead and you will see if it's fitting properly.
Yeah, okay, let's see what happens.
Over here.
Okay.
Include.
Not quite. No.
Probably something else.
Okay, so. What's that there? That's lead peak there. That is palladium. This peak is chromium. We should have chromium in there. It's got chromium. Cesium, no. Technetium.
Take the highest peak. The rest may be something.
I don't think this,
so.
Yeah.
Okay, so you have 52,000 counts. Mm. I would maybe make a longer evaluation, especially if you want.
Okay,
to
so
see
how do we change that?
Over here.
Okay. Then
especially if you want to see something which is like one person.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
No disconnect. Element identification and line scan, and you can not. I wouldn't change the resolution, but it's up to you. Depends.
But
the pixel, a time or number of passes maybe. So if you want to have a quick scan, keep low time and more passes. So if you have quicker scan along the whole line, and then you have more multiple
imaging. So let's do 60, there you go, 2 minutes 33. And we'll do a line in a similar place here, I guess. Well, that's the carbon. It's a lot of carbon there on the first hit. And there's the zinc again. We should have nickel, iron and chrome on the outside. Yeah, you should have nickel, iron and chrome.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's mostly iron, but...
Chromium is 6%, much smaller.
Well, it's different where we are. And then the zinc on the inside there. I'm going to make that colour red.
Oops. Here we have. So now you have selected only this.
Yeah.
I was just like a little bit surprised at all the rest of the lines disappear.
Oh, yeah, I've been doing this all day.
Then I realized this is really... Okay, it's 4:06.
Yeah, so...
So I believe this is the last...
Yeah, this is the last sample.
Are you going to...
It's all okay, I took a later train today.
Yeah.
So my hypothesis is in this area, since I received the sample in 2000, late 2017, was that there is a monopole-like structure at the tip of this triangle, and the material is pulled in and condensed. So, I expected to see a heavier element in there.
That's life.
Not always. Quite often it isn't what I expect. I mean, I didn't know what it would be. I kind of thought there would be something a little bit heavier than zinc, but... The fact there is absolutely zero zinc on the outside of the original material, and you go across the boundary, there's this carbon outside, and then the heavier material on the inside. Oh, John. Oh, manganese. Where's the manganese? Oh, that's the manganese
he's doing the other end. I'm going to go to the next one.